Well, I tried.
It's the Anarchy with me on the SIGI!
A lot of these old iMacs seem to suffer from graphical issues after some time. Some say this is because solder joints fail from constantly heating up and cooling down while mounted vertically. A common fix is heating up the card in the oven, placed horizontally. This is a temporary fix, but it's the only affordable one there is. You can't just put any other card in there. You can obviously buy a second-hand card, but that will most probably fail for the same reason after a while. We're going to find out if the oven fix works on this machine today. To get to the card, we have to remove some components. First, we remove the memory, because everyone seems to do that. I later found out this is completely unnecessary, by the way. Next, we need to remove the glass. Many how-tos mention the need of suction cups to do so. I don't have them, and I don't intend to buy them either. But lo and behold...
Duct tape, ooh, pull the glass out with a little duct tape, ooh.
Next, we'll get the bezel off, which is held in place by 12 T9 screws and one connector at the top, which I believe is from the microphone. This is the order in which they came out. Not sure if that's the original order. It's quite dirty on the left side, but not so much on the right side. Interesting. Next, we need to remove the actual screen by removing some T9 screws again and disconnecting three cables. And here's the naked iMac in all its glory. At this point, I started to question my decision to try and fix this one. You see, most models have the graphics card for grabs at this point. Not this one. It's attached to this heatsink, which is held in place with a single screw at the other side. So we need to remove the whole mainboard. Yay! After removing and disconnecting the right speaker, and these connectors, and these two, and all screws in a weird order because I figured out which one needed to go on the fly, I could finally pull the board out. Let's get that screw out, disconnect the thermal sensor, and remove the graphics card. There it is. Next, we'll remove the heatsink from the GPU. I think someone has tried this before. These thermal pads apparently have never touched anything. I don't think they need to be covered anyway, because the heatsink doesn't reach there. Only the metal bracket does. Let's clean it up before putting it in the oven. Alright, cleaned it up and preheated the oven at 200 degrees Celsius. I'll put it in for about 8 minutes. There we've got our freshly baked graphics card. Let's put some new toothpaste onto it. Now screw the heatsink back in place. Next, I put everything together in reverse order, but I didn't put the bezel and the glass back yet. Let's see if it works first. Looking good! I did have to disassemble it all again, because I forgot to connect the GPU's temperature gauge, which is located at the back of the board. Because of this, the fans were constantly running at full speed. Tried to assemble again, but failed to get the bezel on. Because apparently, these two screws go somewhere else, and the one from the bezel should go through. After I fixed that, all went on again fine, and we got to test our fully assembled system again. It works! I didn't want to erase the owner's hard drive to test Linux, so I decided to boot something from a stick. There's Opelman Driver's intro sound, so the speakers work. Wi-Fi didn't work, and googling that, I found that a lot of people have issues with Wi-Fi on Linux on these things. If you want to run Linux, I think it's a good idea to change this wireless adapter for something that's supported in Linux. I just plugged an Ethernet cable into the back for this test. Bluetooth does seem to work, or well, at least it finds my phone. Here's NeoFetch, showing us we've got an iMac 8.1 with a 3GHz Core 2 Duo, 4GB of RAM, and the card we've just fixed is a GeForce 8800M GTS. We don't have the right drivers here and I don't intend to install them, but we can see it works fine even in 3D when running TuxRacer. I don't want to push it because I know for a fact that this card is gonna break again sooner or later. I found a company that actually repairs these cards by replacing the chip. That will put you back 325 euros, which is about the same in US dollars. Is it worth it? I personally don't think so. Want to buy one of these old iMacs? Don't. Unless you feel like doing what I just did on a regular basis or spend a lot of money to actually fix the issue. You've got one that works fine and want to run a decent OS? Do it! These things are capable as fuck. They're fully 64-bit, so no UEFI issues like I got on a Mac Pro. Click this video if you'd like to see me struggle with that one. I guess that's all I have for you today. I hope you liked this video. Until next time.